Be merciful, even as your Father is merciful. Judge not, and you will not be judged. Welcome to the 11th day of a journey from wilderness to Calvary. My dear brethren in Christ, did you ever notice the most dangerous three things of our minds? Yes. The first one is comparing. Our minds compare to whatever we see. And secondly, the second dangerous thing of our mind is to judge people. And third dangerous thing, or maybe a positive thing, could be imagination. Sometimes we imagine things which do not happen, or sometimes we have a beautiful thing of imagination to imagine great things. Well, today, as we meditate on the second aspect, the second dangerous aspect of our mind, which is judging, I'm sure as you all see this video, as you're watching, I'm sure you already started judging, imagining, and also comparing. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, today, Jesus invites us and tells us not to judge. Not to judge. And why do we judge people? You know, there are four reasons why we judge. The first reason is that we judge people to boost our self-image. Which means to say, I judge a particular person because my self-image is not higher. And by speaking about the person, I try to boost my self-image. That's the first thing. And the second thing is that we take pleasure in hearing about others or sharing a bad news and shortcomings of the others. We take pleasure in speaking about the shortcomings of the others. And that's why we judge. And third thing, why do we judge people, is because it points to us how strong we are. We want to show to the people that person is very weak, but I am very strong. And that's why we judge. And the fourth reason that we judge is to let out our hurt or a revengeful attitude. Because that person, I don't like that person, and therefore I was hurt by him. Let me in turn hurt him and take a revenge on him. This may not be consciously, but we do it subconsciously, which because of the wounds that we have in our mind. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, to such events, Jesus today invites us and gives us a beautiful remedy for judging. He says, be merciful as your heavenly Father is merciful. Be compassionate as your heavenly Father is compassionate. Why are we to show mercy and compassion to the people? Because, firstly, we do not know the circumstances, the pains, the person, the situation of the person, what he is into, and we easily judge. And therefore Jesus says that you do not know what circumstances, what pain, what suffering the person is going through. Therefore, be compassionate and be merciful. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, let me tell you a small incident where I read about, you know, a person was traveling in a car, and in front of him there's another car which was going very slowly. And this man who is behind him started grumbling, scolding, started saying ill things about this man. And suddenly he saw a tag which was put onto the car, which said, physically handicapped. Kindly be patient with this. After reading this, the one who is behind this physically handicapped car was feeling so bad. Why was he grumbling and saying all ill things to this person? When he went home, he was feeling, you know, I am little late, but that doesn't bother. But I have cursed the person. I have cursed the physically handicapped person. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, this is what happens to all of us. We do not know what the other person is going through, what pain he's into, and we simply judge. Therefore, Jesus says, be merciful and be compassionate as your heavenly Father is compassionate. Secondly, why we need to be merciful and compassionate is because we are all sinners. We are all prone to do mistakes. We are all prone to commit sins. And that's why in the first letter of John, chapter 1, verses 18, we hear, if you say that you have no sin, we deceive ourselves and truth is not in us. What a wonderful thing. Every one of us, again, the letter to Romans clearly tells us that every one of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, which means to say everybody is prone to fall. Everybody is prone to have shortcomings in their life. And that's why be merciful as your heavenly Father is merciful. And thirdly, why we need to be merciful? Because the Father who loves us all, even if we fall, He makes us to get up. He gives us the strength. Who are we to judge a person? Sometimes God makes us to fall into the pit, into the situations where He makes us to realize the mistake of others or mistake of our own self. And that's why in the Romans chapter 14 verses 4, we read, who are you to judge someone else's servant to his own master's? He stands or falls, and he will stand for the Lord, and is able to make him stand. The Lord will make him stand if he even falls. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, again, in the Gospel of Luke chapter 6, verses 36 to 37, Jesus says, be merciful just as your Father is merciful. Do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, judging others is something bad, and it is worst. And it is like a poison which kills our peace of mind. As we are in the Lent, let's meditate on this. Let's make correction of our own selves. And let's not pass on judgments to people without knowing their situations. At the same time, pray to God that others also understand our situation and pray for us. May this Lent help us to grow much closer to God. Amen. If you like this video, share and comment, and at the same time kindly contribute for the progress of this channel, Liturgy TV. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.